It's Randy.
And Nova, and we're out for our morning cup of coffee.
And a few people have asked about how we make our coffee when we're out on our bikes. So I thought I'd just make a short little video showing our coffee kit and how we go about making our coffee. So there's basically two different kits I guess I carry for when we're out to make coffee. We'll start with the kind of bigger one first, I guess. In this DeWalt tool bag, this is our pot and stove. This is the coffee maker, AeroPress. It's to make pressed coffee. And my favorite mug. We really like these carabiner mugs. When not carrying it in the bag, you can clip it on your backpack or your bike or your belt loop. Coffee. Got a repurposed Fireball bottle with oat milk. Coffee grinder. But we rarely use it because it just takes so long. We generally grind our coffee at home in an electric grinder every couple days. And in here, I have a folding dripper stand made by Snow Peak. And I don't use it all that often. And a couple of lighters. And as for the water we bring, we generally put warm water in a insulated bottle, just so the water will heat up quicker and save on fuel a little bit. So we've had really good luck with this stove, and I think it's only like $11. I'll leave a link to most everything we use down in the description if I can find it. So while I'm getting the stove set up, Nova's job is generally to pour our water and get the press ready. I've got an older video of a coffee kit I used to use, which included a beer can alcohol stove, and I'll link to that down below. So a few years ago, in an effort to cut back on my caffeine consumption, I made a rule for myself that my second cup of coffee each day had to be consumed away from home. That way I just didn't sit around all morning drinking cup after cup of coffee. And then lately, to further try and cut back on my caffeine consumption, my first cup of coffee I have at home has been decaf. So that's even more motivation to get out on the bike and go get that second cup of coffee to get my caffeine fix. We've been pretty pleased with this AeroPress, and we use it at home quite a bit also. Milk.
Whoa. Yeah.
Here's to a beautiful morning.
Cheers.
Mm. So if I'm on a bike that doesn't have a basket to carry that bag, or I just want to travel lighter, I'll put a kit in this little barrel bag and either attach it to the handlebars or the seat. So in here I've got some pre-ground coffee for drip. And then our pot, stove, and dripper stand.
Drip coffee. Pour over.
Is it a pour over or a drip? Drip coffee is in it.
Pour over. Yeah. Okay, coffee number two, pour over. Obviously the same pot and stove. For the pour-over, we got this neat little collapsible pour-over stand that fits real nicely in the pot. Filters, I just use a regular drip coffee maker coffee filter. And like I said, we typically pre-grind the coffee at home with an electric grinder. So this method is a little more time consuming because you're just dripping or pouring over one at a time, and that takes a little while. There you are, dear.
Thank you.
Y'all typically just reuse her filter and grounds and add a little bit more to it.
What?
Oh.
Your head's cut off.
Earlier. Oh, that's what you did. You hit
I
one
hit
time.
I hit it.
I had it.
Damn it.
Oh, my chocolate melted all over the place.
Whatever you want.
Yeah,
you can have this
one. Oh, man. So much for my chocolate. Yeah, what a mess. Yeah. Okay, where were we? Oh, we were making coffee. Shot of oatmeal.
Hey!
Want a piece?
No. Thank you, anyway. Man, this is nice back here, though. Especially since the wind's out of the south. Protected.
Enough of that. So as for the coffee we use...
For the press, we use Bustelo.
Yeah, which is obviously already ground and
cheap
and made for a press. And the beans we buy are all over the place, from the cheapest beans that the grocery store has to beans from one of the local roasters in town here.
We're not that picky.
That didn't make sense what you just said. Mm-hmm. That's it.
And there you have it. That's how we typically go about making coffee. So I hope you could find or get something useful out of this mess of a video.
Thanks for watching.